This is how to make this trending 2.5D parallax image effect in After Effects. So start by creating a Photoshop project. Now import the image and scale it up so it fits inside the frame. We need to isolate each object on the image on a single layer. Since I have a foreground, a person and a background, I will duplicate the image 3 times by pressing Ctrl and J. On the top layer, select your first object using the selection tool and you can create a mask for the object. Now isolate the second layer by alt clicking and then create a selection for your second object and then create a mask for it again. Now on top of the background layer, you need to create a new layer to remove the objects. You can use generative fill or the remove tool for this. And then you can simply remove the objects from the image. Then select the background layer and the object removed layer that we created. Then right click and select convert to smart object. Go to file, save as, and then save it somewhere easy. Now open After Effects and then drag your Photoshop project inside it. And make sure the import kind is set to composition and editable layer styles is checked. Now drag the comp to your main composition and then double click to open it. Now to create the parallax effect, you need to make all your layers 3D by pressing on this icon and then create a camera by right clicking new and then camera, and then you can use the default settings. Now select all your Photoshop layers and then press P for position, and then change the third position value, which is the Z axis, to move it back in space, and do this for your background layer first, and you can move it back to around 1000, and then do the same with the next layer, but don't move it further than the background layer. And for the foreground rocks, you don't want to move it further than the person or object that you have. Now select your layers and press S for scale, and then simply scale them up so they cover the screen like the original image. Now to create the zoom, select the camera layer and then make sure you're at the start of clip, and then press P for position. And create a keyframe for position, move to the end of the layer and then increase the third position value. And this is how it looks.